Hi, AT from CNC at home. I have a project that I've been getting material ready for and it's time to do it. I want to etch on the business cards that have no coating on them, that are essentially the aluminum color. And to do that, I'll need to put some stuff on there. I bought this compound and we mix it with denatured alcohol up to here, shake it up, apply it to the card, and then laser it, and supposedly it turns back black and etches on there and stays. I also have these business card holders, and I etched my name on here and you can't see a thing. I don't know if it's because it's green or what, but I did it twice, slowed down the laser, increased the power, nothing's coming through. So I'm hoping that this stuff will do the trick on that as well. Give this video a thumbs up. Let's go get the denatured alcohol and start mixing. See how this works. I didn't film putting the denatured alcohol into the bottle. It's just pouring it in. It's kind of boring. I did fill it up to this bottom line, and this is for brushing it on. That's how I'm going to do it. It very specifically says stir well. I'm going to make a big assumption that this is actually called a suspension, where the denatured alcohol acts as something just to hold the particles, and then we can paint it on. The denatured alcohol will evaporate quickly, leaving whatever the magic powder is coated on our material. So let's get that done. We'll get a brush, paint some of this on, and we will go into light burn and we will do a material test. Have no clue what settings we're going to need, so that material test is just a fantastic way to get started. Let's go get that done. This is the business card painted with our compound. I just used this little styrofoam brush that came with it. Now we just need to let this dry and pop it into the laser. We go to our laser tools and come to the material test. Let's get zoomed in on that so you can see what I'm setting here. Let's go to our laser tools and pull up the material test. What I will do is I'll do my power from 55 to 100 and we'll set the size to 2.5. We found that that is a good size. We did that previously. So 2.5. So we'll go from 1,000 millimeters per minute up to 1,900 millimeters per minute. That should work okay. Let's get switched over to our laser and start testing. With our material in place, we'll just run a frame that looks good. We'll start the burn. Well, it etched on the metal, however, the black didn't stay behind. So apparently there is a coating on these clear aluminum ones, and you can see that everything did what it was supposed to. I'm going to coat the back of this and try some slower settings, see if we can heat this material up a little bit, see what it does. After cleaning, this one at least has some black on it. The bad news is that top row is 100 millimeters per minute, so that's pretty slow for this laser. There are some black at the 190% at 200. Let's see if we can get in a little bit closer on that. On camera it looks quite a bit better. In real life, we could maybe go down to 90% at 200. Otherwise, yeah, it's starting to look more gray than black. Anyway,
It means we can use this. Let's put a case in there and see what that does. Well, that turned out pretty well. I don't want to scrub too hard on that. I don't know how well that black's gonna stay on there. For a initial test, that turned out well. I'm gonna do some more burning testing with this, see how well it works. I've been having some really mixed results with that liquidy compound make it black etching on metal stuff. We did one sample, it came out like nothing on it, and so I tried again and it came out with some, but the more I cleaned it, the more the stuff came off. So it's just not sticking real well. Now, these aluminum business cards do have some sort of coating on them, so maybe if I can get that cleaned off, I can get right to the raw metal. I don't know. I also tried it again. It's really slow speeds. I don't know if you can see that, but I did some slow speeds. I did 60 to 180, I think is what it is. I can't have my glasses on. I can't read it. And then the power settings were really low as well. So, yeah, I went from 80% power to 100% power across this, and from 60 to 180 millimeters per minute. So, fairly slow, and it looked really great until I washed it off. It still looked great, and then I dried it with a terry cloth towel, and it started just pulling the stuff off. I don't know if you can see that. So it's not working that well. And then I have some, let me grab some of these here. I have some business card holders that I purchased. And I have a green one that I tried putting a name on, and it pretty much just came off. It didn't quite rinse off, but as I was drying it with the cloth, most of it came off, and I was able to just scrape it all off with my thumb. So I tried it again, and the black just washed off. It didn't even turn black on the whole thing. I tried another spot, same issue. So I'm gonna not abandon this stuff for now, but I was thinking about how we use the cold galvanizing compound. Let me just grab that. Remember the cold galvanizing compound? We used that on tiles. That seemed to work pretty well. So I'm thinking, what if we take the business card holder and I put some masking tape on it and I painted it with the cold galvanizing compound? Can't hurt. I've tried engraving something on this 4 times and there's kind of a ghost image on there, sort of, but for the most part, nothing. So I've masked this off. We've got the cold galvanizing compound. I'm going to throw it in the laser. We'll see what happens. I'm putting names onto these business card holders as little presents to the dads at the Buck Frenzy weekend that's coming up. Well, long story short, that didn't work. I went to clean it up and everything just rinsed right off. However, I did find that when I switched to the business card case, I had forgotten to refocus the laser. So that's why it wasn't working. So I've recoded this and I'm going to give it another shot. 12 times the charm. Ugh. Let's make sure we're in focus. Thank you.
It isn't going to work to have black etching on a black case, so for Keith's, I'm putting a piece of masking tape on there and using the laser to burn a template. Once this is done burning, I'm going to peel away the letters and spray paint it with silver paint. Hopefully that'll turn out nicely. Now that the burn is done, I'll need to remove all the little pieces, leaving just Keith's name on there for spray painting. It turned out pretty well. Each one of these I coated with a clear coating to help protect the dark part of that, because it didn't stick on too well. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, and if you enjoy the content of our channel, think about subscribing. Enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.
Oops.